Now we are going to study the facial nerve. Our topic is facial nerve. This facial nerve, first we'll start with the surface marking, where only two points are necessary. Please draw alongside with me. As usual, coronoid process, this will be the condyloid process, the neck and the angle of mandible. This we have to draw. And over here, there will be the zygomatic arch, lower border of zygomatic arch, mandibular fossa, and here this will serve as external acoustic meatus. And just behind the external acoustic meatus, there will be mastoid process. So mastoid process, external acoustic meatus, and this is the mandibular fossa. This is the head of the mandible. This is the neck of the mandible. And of course, this is the angle. It will start with the body of mandible. This is the angle. Now here, what we have to mark will be, there will be the first point which we have to mark is the point which is present at the level of mastoid process, anterior border of the mastoid process, at the level of anterior border of mastoid process, the first point. Because at this point, exactly at this point, 2 cm deep will be stylomastoid foramen. Deep to this point, 2 cm, stylomastoid foramen, where the facial nerve will exit from the skull, from the intracranial cavity. The facial nerve will come outside through stylomastoid foramen, which is present 2 cm deep to this point. Second point which is taken will be the neck. This is the neck posterior border. So here we mark the surface marking second point. This is the posterior border at the neck of the mandible. Now if we join this, this will serve as the facial nerve, where it will enter the substance of parotid gland. As we know, the parotid gland which is present over here, this will enter from posteromedial surface. This is where the facial nerve will enter from the posteromedial surface. And therefore, this is the surface marking of facial nerve. This is the extracranial part of the facial nerve. Remember, this is the extracranial part of facial nerve. From here, it will enter parotid gland and then it will divide. It will pass out of the anterior border by dividing into 5 terminal branches, which we have discussed. Here, we start with this surface marking. It is very clear. This is the extracranial part of the facial nerve. Now, we go back to the actual facial nerve, where we start the facial nerve with the help of nuclei. How many nuclei are there in facial nerve? Any cranial nerve has several nuclei, which are located in the brainstem. So, therefore, the nuclei which are present in the brainstem of the facial nerve will be, the first nucleus will be motor nucleus of the facial nerve. Second nucleus will be known as superior salivatory nucleus, which will serve as a parasympathetic nucleus of facial nerve. From here, superior salivatory nucleus, it will send its fibers to submandibular sublingual salivary glands. Then the third nucleus, which is present, will be also parasympathetic, which will be known as lacrimatory nucleus. So obviously from this it will send its fibers to the pterygopalatine ganglion, from there to the lacrimal gland and its various fascia, etc. And the last nucleus of the facial nerve will be known as the sensory nucleus, or it will be known as nervus intermedius. Please be careful. Nervus intermedius is another name of the sensory nucleus. One mark question answer, it can be asked, what is nervus intermedius? So these are the 4 nuclei of the facial nerve. Motor nucleus of facial nerve, superior salivary nucleus of facial nerve, which will serve as parasympathetic, it will carry secretomotor fibers. Then lacrimatory nucleus, which will also serve as the parasympathetic, and the nervus intermedius, which is the sensory nucleus of the facial nerve. So altogether, these 4 nuclei will consist of the group of facial nerve nuclei present in the brainstem. From here, these fibers of facial nerve will pass as facial nerve. So together, from all these nuclei, the fibers will pass as facial nerve. From these 3, it will pass as motor root, and from this it will pass as sensory root. Together they will travel and enter. Where will they enter? They will enter internal acoustic meatus, which we will show you during demonstration classes. They will enter the internal acoustic meatus along with another cranial nerve, which is known as eighth. That is the vestibulocochlear nerve. So along with vestibulocochlear nerve, these two roots will enter the internal acoustic meatus. Now a cross section at internal acoustic meatus, a cross section at internal acoustic meatus, draw this cross section. This is the cross section at internal acoustic meatus, in which the vestibulocochlear nerve will be present in this format. This is the vestibulocochlear nerve, a cross section, once again I repeat, in the concavity of vestibulocochlear nerve, within the concavity of the vestibulocochlear nerve, if I mark this as vestibulocochlear nerve, eighth cranial nerve, within this there will be this motor root of facial nerve, and in between this motor root and the vestibulocochlear nerve, a small root which will be known as nervus intermedius, that is sensory root. So motor root of facial nerve, sensory root, that is nervus intermedius, and together these are known as the facial nerve. This, both the components, they are present within the concavity of vestibulocochlear nerve, and this arrangement is found where these nerves enter the internal acoustic meatus. Once they enter, I'll just rub it off. So once they enter this internal acoustic meatus, it will enter the petrous portion of temporal bone, where it will enter the facial canal. Now within the facial canal, once again, if we draw this facial canal, we divide it by a crest, in which we will show that how the components are divided. Here, there will be fusion of these two components. Both the motor and sensory components will fuse, and they will be represented as one facial nerve. Then, just behind the facial nerve, there will be representation of the vestibulocochlear nerve, which will divide into its various fibers. This will be the superior vestibular area or superior vestibular component. This will be the inferior vestibular area or inferior vestibular component. Then, below this facial, there will be the cochlear component. These three components, superior vestibular, inferior vestibular, and cochlear, will form vestibulocochlear nerve. And this will be the facial nerve. So, this is the diagram where both the components will fuse. The motor and sensory component of facial nerve will fuse. And inside the facial canal, this is the division. Once again, I'll rub this. After this, we would like to show how the course of the facial nerve is present in facial canal and how it will exit from the stylomastoid foramen.